transient canvas premiere of 6 new composers' works. This has been in the work since last September, and we've had several date changes and several new waves of COVID to deal with, but in the end, we've lucked out because we still have a concert to put on. Woo. Yay, I know, it's pretty exciting. Working with Amy and Matt has been incredibly exciting over the past 2 days. They're two lovely people, and they're some of the most amazing musicians that I've ever worked with. Transient Canvas is a Boston-based duo, bass clarinet and marimba. They have done residencies across the country, and they have put out several fantastic albums, which all of you should check out. Without further ado, let's get going with Transient Canvas. Thank you all for being here.
To work with all the composers here at the university on these new pieces. Every single one of these pieces on the program is brand new, never been performed. So it's really exciting. First piece is by William Mollenkamp, who I hope will come up and join us to talk about his piece. Yeah.
We should note that there's a piece that's been added to the program, so there will be one piece after the last piece on your program.
Yeah, and
we'll talk about that later.
Don't run out the door after Ben Tufte's piece.
Yeah, don't just like run out.
Yeah. I mean, you have to leave then. What can we do?
Thank you. Thank you.
Sometimes it's good luck. I got a better result, and I think Andy also did. So.
Thank you.
And next up is Bradley Quartz. Bradley.
This piece is, it was meant to be five movements, but I did not get to the other ones, and that's okay. So I have kind of an incomplete thing about, you know, someone walking to a track station and then waiting and then eventually getting on, and then it leaves. So I just kind of do that every day, that I have to get to Salt Lake because I don't have a car, but I also really like public transit, stuff like that. And there's also a little joke I put in there that I thought was funny. I really like using the light rail here because it's just, I think it's a cool thing. I think it's good for society and stuff like that too.
Right on.
All right.
Thank you.
take this off for a second. Next piece is called Hell Out. This comes from a quote from Heidegger, but that I sort of made up. Like, I took some of the words and I used them to make it sound like what I wanted. So the quote goes, human beings are held out into the nothing. And I sometimes feel that in Salt Lake City. It's kind of this outpost. And if you head towards the Salt Lake, it just sort of ends. Heidegger never said that, but I wish he had. And so here's Held Out. Thank you.
That was a little extra something, just for you all. It's pretty expensive, actually. We're not gonna cry till afterwards. Is Ben here? Yes, come on up. Ben just played a recital right before this. He's a real trooper. Amazing.
First, I would like to thank everybody for coming. The title of my piece refers to my feeling while writing it and having to do so very, very quickly. I hope you all enjoy it. Thank you.
Crystal Pascucci. Crystal is a cellist, improviser, and composer based in Oakland, California. We met her way too long ago now.
It was a long time ago.
When we were doing a residency with the Composers Collective out there. And Crystal's an amazing performer. This is the first piece she's ever notated up until the point she wrote Resonance Imaging in 2016. Everything she'd done had been graphic notation or improv. And Crystal is, she has lupus, which is a chronic illness that causes chronic pain, basically always. And so as part of her life experience, she spends an incredible amount of time in MRIs. And this piece is partially a transcription of the sound of an MRI. Have any of you ever been in an MRI? It's kind of an unforgettable sonic experience, right? And so she has woven the natural music and rhythms of the MRI machine into this piece, which also goes through different stages of what it feels like to have a chronic illness. You know, despair and joy and overcoming and then despair again and the complicated emotions associated with that. So thank you all for having us. We hope you like it. If you like this piece, it's on our third album now in a second, which is available on all streaming services, etc.
Wonderful. Wonderful plug. We have albums. There's more. You haven't got enough of the best kind of Marimba.
But get them on Bandcamp. Okay.
Yes.
Thanks again. Thanks to Chris for being an amazing host and taking care of us. And hope you enjoy.
One of the fun things about working with living composers, as we've been doing, is the creative sound palettes that everyone captures that makes their piece very individual, even with just two instruments, right? You may have heard some of these techniques tonight. I might as well show some of you if you're interested. There's this really great technique that is going to be in this piece as well called the slap tongue, and I love to display it, so I will. He's like, it's okay. So what I do to make a slap tongue is I'm going to create a very percussive sound. I'm going to be a percussionist when I do it, put my whole tongue on the reed, and then I create like a suction cup. And when I pull my tongue away from the reed is actually going to physically hit the mouthpiece. And so what you're going to hear is this big thwack. Mm.
us, feel free to, if you want to, come up and talk to us. We're not that scary.
We'll put our masks back on.
Or if you want to, like, look at the music,
yeah,
see what we did, we're always happy to chit-chat.
You can check our work, make sure we got all the right notes.
That's true.
Yeah.
Thanks again.
All right, thanks.